Hey guys, Advocor Cosplay here, and today we're going to be talking about racism in cosplay. Now, I felt the need to talk about this as the current climate has been focusing in on police brutality and the issue of race. Cosplay is no stranger to racism, and any cosplayer of color would tell you that. Unfortunately, many cosplayers of color face discrimination and harassment from within the cosplay community itself. Now, the initial trigger for me to talk about this was a post in the Cosplayers Australia Facebook page. I don't have a screenshot of the deleted post, but basically they stated that they didn't want any posts about the Black Lives Matter movement or the protests, as they wanted the page to be purely about cosplay. After some backlash and some clever posts like this Black Lives Matter protest cosplay, they went into full damage control, and to their credit, made a specific thread for these discussions to be had. This did make me want to ask some questions though, like, is cosplay meant to be politics free? What does cosplay look like for people of color, and how can we support cosplayers of color while trying to lessen the racism in the community? To start with, is cosplay meant to be politics free? To be honest, I completely disagree with any premise that certain interests are meant to be politics free. You hear this argument a lot in sports, oh I don't want politics in my sports, shut up and play the game. However, there are real issues in the world, and though you might want to watch sports to get away from that, it doesn't make the issues any less real. The black basketballer could be murdered by the police the next day, and now not only is a life lost because we didn't address the issue, it has a compounding effect which now affects the sport that you so love. To ignore the issues because you just want them to
shut up and dribble
is both demeaning and selfish. Now, cosplay is often described one of two ways, the most wonderful people and accepting community people have ever known, or the most drama-inducing, angry, bigoted community they have ever known. And there is truth to both. I will be making a video on generic cosplay drama in the future, so please check out my channel to see more, but specifically, here we are talking about race. Nothing is inherently politics-free, though this also assumes that politics is a genre, hobby, or group on its own. The way people talk about it in this context is like saying, I don't want to talk about Star Wars during my football game. Star Wars can have all sorts of discussion, though a football game probably isn't an appropriate time to do so. Whereas politics, and I'm using air quotes there, is systemically a part of the way our society works. Nothing is not affected by policy, and the modern issues surrounding our society are important to every facet of life. Specifically in cosplay, there are many social issues that we are still addressing and must continue to work toward in order to achieve a community in which people can enjoy their hobby. But in order to enjoy it without having discussions about it simply won't happen. We cannot silence a portion of our community because others don't want to discuss it. By making a statement that only cosplay discussion is allowed, groups are ignoring the plight of cosplayers of color and the racism in the community, whilst also not allowing our community to progress to a place where everyone feels accepted. This is, after all, what makes cosplay so alluring, that we are supposedly accepting of anyone. As to how can we support cosplayers of color? Well, I spoke to cosplayer and maker Neverending Dreams about his experiences and his views on these issues. Speaking to where he experiences these problems, he said this.
For me, it's definitely social media. I don't really have it in person. I don't know if I just look intimidating in the costumes that I have or what it is, but I never really see it in person, but you see it all the time on social media. I mean, when it comes to like actual racism, like I said, it is more of a social media thing. I do have friends where, you know, they could be cosplaying a character at a con. It actually just happened at KatsuCon back in February. She was cosplaying Nezuko from Demon Slayer. And they told her, you know, she's too dark to be that character. And she's not even black. She's Hispanic. They just told her like her skin tone is too dark to be that character, and it kind of like ruined her con experience. And for me, like seeing her upset, I mean, it kind of just let me know that there are people out there that do it physically in person, but I've just never experienced it. There's certain people like in their head that the ideal image, if you do a costume, it has to be perfect all the way down to the skin tone. And I think that's where the issue is, because to me, skin tone is not part of the costume at all, you know? And a lot of people don't see it that way. A lot of people think, you know, hey, you're doing this character, your skin tone needs to match this character because that's part of the costume. skin tone is just not a costume. It's not a prop or something you just add on.
Here we come to one of the big issues, which is skin tone and the concept of blackface in cosplay. Like he explained, sometimes people will be told that they are too dark to play a character, and this is a sad reality of the community. These are often the same people who strive for the hyper-realism in their characters. But we also discuss the opposite end of the spectrum as well, that being white cosplayers darkening their skin to be more accurate to the character. Some people will use products or paint to darken their skin in order to look closer to the character they are playing, whilst others may naturally tan their skin. This was an interesting discussion as to where the line is and as to what is and isn't appropriate.
I personally don't care, just as long as they don't, you know, race face, black face, or, you know, brown face. Like when I cosplay someone whose skin tone is more of a whiter complexion, I don't sit there and put on a bunch of makeup to make myself look white. So I don't feel like if they cosplay someone who has African descent or any type of POC complexion, they shouldn't have to alter their skin tone to match the costume. I don't feel like skin tone is part of a costume. Like, if you feel like someone's skin tone is part of a costume, then you're looking at the whole scenario wrong. You know, like, you should never have to alter your skin tone for acting. You know, because there are people whose skin tone are naturally that color, and they don't get to take that off. Like, it's cool for some people to feel like, hey, you know, I could be this black person or this Indian person, you know, for the day as I match this con. But when the con's over, you get to take that off. You know, people who are actually that race don't. And that's kind of the problem is. It's like, you know, like, I'm black 24/7, so I don't get to take that off after a con.
There are many reasons why blackfacing is wrong, but like Dreams is saying here, people get to take that off at the end of the day, whilst others never can. I agree with him, and when put in this context, it appears as if cosplayers who do this are simply using another race to their benefit when it suits them, and taking it off when it doesn't, whilst black cosplayers have to deal with racism issues every hour of every day. Now I imagine some people would say, well, black people can lighten up, look at Michael Jackson. But the point is that they shouldn't have to change because of the actions of others. It is the unacceptable behavior that needs to change. Personally, if you naturally tan your body, then I don't see it as a problem, as that is both your own skin, and it's extremely likely not coming off at the end of the convention. But like Dream said, makeup and products that artificially darken the skin, which can be removed at any point, encourage using race to one's benefit, while it suits them, without understanding what it actually means to be a part of that community. There is one more thing that crosses my mind when I see cosplayers doing blackface, and Dream sums it up quite well in this clip.
In most cases where I even see people changing their skin tone, doesn't even come across well anyway. So I don't know, I feel in some cases it may be an insecurity issue where they feel like they have to go that extra mile to try to quote unquote be accurate, but in most cases it just doesn't even look remotely convincing to begin with, and then it's just wrong out of the gate. So
there is one more thing that I want to touch on, and that is when people perceive someone's race before judging their costume. It could simply be reflexive, but dismissing some of the amazing work that black cosplayers put into their costumes diminishes their effort and skill. Cosplay shouldn't be about identity. It should be about the craft, the play, and the love of pop culture as we know it. Dreams also gave a very good example of this.
They don't really necessarily care about the quality of the cosplay. Because the first thing they notice is like the skin tone. Like, you can have the most detailed bat suit ever. Like, for all I know, it could have Batman Beyond and the wings could open up, you know, have all that type of stuff. But then the first thing they're going to notice is the complexion. They'll just discredit the entire outfit just because you don't match the complexion.
And at the end of the day, this simply erodes what cosplay is about. It is about the costumes and the characters that we love. And we shouldn't look at two exact same Batmans and think the white one is more accurate. We should love both for the effort and skill put into them. To conclude, the cosplay community has issues with race, like much of the world at the moment. I don't think it's too much to ask that we listen and understand that our words and actions affect others, and to think about things before acting on them. And when in doubt, it's okay to ask, is this okay? There are people who will help you understand. And it's our responsibility, if not our duty, to talk about these issues instead of sliding them under the rug. You can find me on Facebook and Instagram, and a special thank you to Neverending Dreams. I'll pop a link in the description to find him and his amazing Keyblade work. Until next time, it's pure imagination.